ABC are events such that PA equals 0.2, PB 0.1, PC 0.3. A and B are independent, B and C are independent, A and C are mutually exclusive. Calculate probability A union B union C. Now, A and B independent means the probability of A and B equals PAPB. So P A and B equals PAPB. Remember, this was our convention of A and B. We just write it as AB. Similarly, B and C are independent, so probability BC equals PBPC. Now, A and C are mutually exclusive. That means that they cannot occur at the same time. So probability of AC equal to zero. And probability of AC equal to zero automatically implies that probability of ABC is also equal to zero, because if A and C cannot occur together, then it means A and B and C also cannot occur at the same time. Okay, so we use the generalized addition rule. We have to find probability of A union B union C, and we know that that's equal to PA plus BB plus PC, and then you subtract the pairs, minus PAB minus PAC minus PBC, and then you add the triplet PABC. And then we use the fact that PAB is PAPB, PAC is zero, and PBC is PBBC, and PABC is zero, and substitute the values of PA, PB, and PC. PA was 0.2, PB was 0.1, PC was 0.3, and substitute them here and here as well. We end up with 0.55, that was choice D.